Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to my channel. If you're new, I'm Kelly. This is KBellaBeauty. And Happy New Year! I'm pretty sure this is going to be the first video that I put up in the new year, which means it's also the first video with my brand new camera. So I did get a Canon Rebel T6S for Christmas. No idea how to use it because previously I filmed on my iPhone. Now we are filming on a camera and yeah, there's just a lot to learn. I tried to film some videos yesterday, filmed one, tried to film a couple videos today. They didn't turn out. The autofocus was off, so I'm really hoping I'm in focus right now. But we're just gonna roll with this video. Anyway, I am here to share with you my 2019 project pan. I did the 18 and 2018 project pan where I picked 18 products that I wanted to try to use up or pan in 2018, and I did horrible. I have a whole playlist, so I'll link that here if you're interested in checking that out, but I did not do very well. It was like my first very large project pan, and I gave it a try. I learned a lot from it, and I think I'm ready to try a different approach to my project pan in 2019. I am not picking 19 products. I think I have like 12 products here. I can't do 19. But I did pick some products that I want to try to use up or pan in 2019. So if you're interested in hearing what those products are, go ahead and keep on watching. First up, I do have a couple skincare items that I would like to try and use up. The first being this Garnier Micellar Cleansing Water. This is supposed to remove your makeup, cleanse, and refresh. There's no need to rinse. I always do a double wash. I use this to take off any extra eye makeup that's left over. I typically start with like a cleansing oil, then wash my face and go in after with this bad boy. I did get this a couple months ago, and I'm already right here. I'll insert starting pictures over here as well, but I already have a good dent on it, so I think I will be able to use this up completely in 2019, which would be amazing. That's my goal. Gonna try to use that up completely. And the second item that I picked that is skincare is my Kiehl's Daily Reviving Concentrate. I did get this 2 years ago, I believe, for Christmas. I am already down to here. Again, I'll insert a photo, but I would use this in the morning because it's the Daily Reviving Concentrate. They have a nighttime renewing one or something like that, but there's a nighttime one as well. This is the daytime one, so I would take like 2, 3, 4 drops and put it on my face before my moisturizer. I haven't been using this lately because I did post a video letting you guys know that I am pregnant and my skin is extra, extra dry, and this just wasn't enough. So I've been using another oil. I have the Josie Moran Argan oil that I've been using, and I've been using like 4 to 5 drops before my moisturizer. But this is a product that I would like to use up in 2019. It's winter right now, so it's cold. Well, I mean, I live in Texas, so it's not freezing, but it's colder than it usually is. So once we start to get into spring and I don't need as much hydration, I'll pull this bad boy back out, but I think I'll be able to finish it up this year. Then we move into the beauty products. There is a foundation that I'm gonna try to use up, and it is this guy right here, the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Water Foundation. This has an SPF of 15. I have used a little bit more than half of it. I am very proud of myself. I used this a lot this year. This is a very nice lightweight. If you like full coverage, you probably won't like this. This is a nice lightweight foundation. So I've been really, really enjoying it, but I have more foundations that I'd like to try. However, I wanna make sure that like I'm using them up before they go bad. So I wanna use this up in 2019. I also have a concealer that I wanna use up. You can't even see the name. I've rubbed it off completely. You can see where I am right here on this concealer. But this is the ColourPop, what is it called? The No Filter Concealer in the shade Fair. I don't use this by itself because I find that the ColourPop concealers do crease under my under eye, which is no bueno, but I do like to use this on top of another concealer. So like I was using my Urban Decay Naked Skin, or right now I've been trying out the Becca Aqualuminous concealer. So I'll put that on first. And then because this is a lighter shade, I'll go on top of it. Although this does oxidize a little bit, but I will repurchase this when I run out. I just want to make sure that I'm going ahead and using it and getting it out of my collection. Those are four products that I really feel like I will be able to use 100%. I also picked a product that I knew would be really easy for me, and that is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz. I typically go through maybe two and a half, three of these a year. So I knew for sure I would be able to be successful with this. And I did mark it here. I lined my pencil up with the bottom of the page here. And so far, I have this much product. This is my January mark right here. And like I said, I'll be inserting pictures so you can see better. But I am going to track it, but I'm pretty sure I'll be able to use this up no problem. Then we have some products that I don't know how well I'll do, but we're gonna try. In 2018, I did have a bronzer in there. I had my Benefit Hoola bronzer that I wanted to try and pan, and I did. This was one of the only products that I was actually successful with. I hit pan. These Benefit Boxed blushes are no joke, but I did hit pan. This was the bronzer that I was using every single day. So my goal this year is to increase the pan to get this out of my collection. Not because I don't like it. I actually really, really love this and will probably repurchase it, but I'd like to try out some other bronzers as well. And like I said, I wanna make sure I'm using what I have. So I want to increase pan on that. I will be tracking it with pictures. This one, call me crazy, okay? Call me crazy. I was not successful with my Benefit Rockateur blush that I had in my 2018 project pan. But for blush, I picked my other boxed blush by Benefit. This is in the shade Dallas. Now, this is one of my favorite blushes because it's just a nice neutral mauve shade. When I travel, I sometimes use this as contour as well, just because I feel like it's just like a nice neutral shade and it can kind of carve out the hollows of your cheeks. I have the tiniest baby little dip in there, but I wanna try to make some progress on this. I wanna try to hit some pan. I'll be tracking it. I don't know if we will hit pan, but that's my goal. If we could hit pan like we did with the Hoola bronzer by Benefit, that would be amazing. I also wanted to throw a highlight in here, and this was my first like high-end highlighter that I ever purchased. It is by Becca Cosmetics. It was the collaboration with Jaclyn Hill and Champagne Pop. And I already have a little bit of pan on this guy. I used this. This was the only highlighter that I had for the longest time, and so I was able to hit pan on it. But now I'd like to increase pan, because although this was my only highlighter and I do like it, I actually have other highlighters in my collection that I like even more, but I wanna make sure that I'm using this up. So, I mean, I would be fine with using this up completely and then ditching it at the end of the year, but I thought I already have some pan, so maybe I'll be able to increase the pan on this guy. Last year, I made the mistake of putting two eyeshadow palettes in my project pan, which I thought was, you know, at the time seemed like a good idea, but later I found that was really crazy. So this time I decided to reach into my Makeup Geek Cosmetics single eyeshadows, but I wanted to pick some specific eyeshadows that I'd like to pan. So Shimma Shimma, one of the first eyeshadows that I ever got. It does have a dent in it. I use it as like an inner corner or brow bone highlight. So I'd like to hit pan on that. I would like to increase pan on Beaches and Cream and Creme Brulee. I hit pan on both of those. Those are nice transition shades, so I'd be able to use them even if I'm dipping into other palettes. So I'd like to increase pan on those. And then I also chose Tiki Hut right here on the end to hit pan on as well. This is one that's newer to my collection. There's no dent, there's no dip, nothing. So I wanna see how far we can get on that. But I wanted to pick some shadows that were more neutral that I could use when I'm pulling in other eyeshadows, or even if I decide to step out of my comfort zone and play with color, which does not happen often, I could use those neutral shades with any other shadow to try and, you know, even it out, put those in the crease, and mix and match some shades. I also made the mistake of picking 5 lip products to use up in 2018, and I didn't use up a single one. So we narrowed it down this year. I did pick a new lip liner, and I have the Bite Beauty lip liner right here. This is in the shade 20. What I did was start at the bottom of the page here, and right now when I line it up, I am right here with this Bite Beauty lip liner. But this is a nice nude shade. You can use it underneath anything. Like, I don't have it on under this red, but you could even put nude liner under a red. You could put it under a color. You can put it under a nude, a mauve. So I figured, I've had this lip pencil for a while. I actually got it in an Influenster box. So I wanted to put this in my project pan, see how far we could get on it. Then I decided to pick one regular lipstick and one liquid lipstick. And for the liquid lipstick, I did pick my favorite, my OG. This is by Kylie Cosmetics. It is in the shade Malibu. And I chose it because I'm literally down to here already. Like, I have used so much of this already, but it's one of the older liquid lipsticks in my collection. This is a go-to for me when I don't know what lipstick I want to wear. I typically reach for this one. I want to use it up. I will repurchase if I do use it up because I love this shade. It's my favorite, but I want to use it up before it goes bad. So that is in my project pan, and then the lipstick that I am choosing is this guy right here by Charlotte Tilbury. It is in the shade Kim KW. I love this. It's like a beautiful pinky nude shade, and I'm not putting this in my project pan because I don't like it and I want to use it up. I actually really, really love this lipstick. I'm putting it in my project pan because I want to make sure I use it before it goes bad because it was a gift. So what I did was I started at the bottom and the top of the Kim KW lipstick was right here. So I just want to track my progress, see how far I can get, maybe make a dent, maybe make it down to the little lips that they have on the lipstick there. But I think I can do it. If I only have 2 lippies, I think I can do it because those are lipsticks that I can wear like when I'm at work or just out and about. Gonna be much easier than 5 lipsticks, I believe. I feel like I was talking a mile a minute, but like I said, I have a new camera and I've been having some issues with it. So I've actually tried to film, I think this is my 5th time trying to film today, and all of the other videos didn't work. So I'm really hoping this one works out. But I just wanted to share my products with you that I am going to be trying to pan and use up in 2019. I am hoping this year I am much more successful than last year. I'll be checking in with you guys quarterly, so every 3 months I'll do a little update video, show you how I'm doing, show you what I've used up, if I've used anything up, or let you know my progress to kind of, you know, keep me accountable. So if you are doing a project pan, let me know down below what items you are trying to pan. Make sure to check in with me. Make sure you're subscribed so you can check in with me because I want to hear about your progress and how you guys are doing as well. Otherwise, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye.